What an impertinent thing is a young girl bred in a nunnery. How full of questions. Prithee, no more, Helena. I have told thee more than thou understandst already.
The more is my grief. I would fain know as much as you, which ever makes me so inquisitive. Nor is it enough I know you're a lover, unless you tell me too who 'tis you sigh for.
When you're a lover, I'll think you fit for a secret of that nature.
'Tis true, I never was a lover yet, but I begin to have a shrewd guess what it is to be so, and fancy it very pretty to sigh and sing and blush and wish and dream and wish and long and wish to see the man. And when I do, look pale and tremble, just as you did when my brother brought home that fine English colonel to see you. What do you call him? Don Belville?
Hey, Helena.
That blush betrays you. I am sure to say so. Or is it Don Antonio, the viceroy's son? Or perhaps the rich old Don Vincenzo? When my father designs you for a husband, why do you blush again?
Indignation! And how near soever my father thinks I am to marrying that hated object, I shall let him see. I understand better. That's due my beauty, birth, and fortune, and more to my soul than to obey these unjust commands.
Now hang me. If I don't love thee for that dear disobedience, I love mischief strangely, as most of our sex do, who are come to love nothing else. But tell me, dear Florinda, don't you love that fine Inglés? For I vow next to loving him myself. 'Twill please me most that you do so, for he is so gay and so handsome.
Helena, a maid designed for a nun ought not to be so curious in a discourse of love.
And dost thou think that ever I'll be a nun?